Ho Tao Muga, northeast China. Dozens of skeletons are excavated from an ancient burial site. Bizarrely, around half have regular skulls. The rest defy belief.
You can only imagine the shock of the archaeologists. All of a sudden, these horrifyingly deformed skulls emerge from the ground.
11 out of the 25 skulls appear extremely elongated, with the back of the skull looking stretched several inches.
Some of these skulls measure a fifth larger than normal. They seem a freak of nature.
Skulls are such an essential part of our anatomy. They're where our minds reside. So to see something so strangely deformed, it's just upsetting.
Can new investigative digital analysis finally decipher these cone-shaped heads?
Thinking about how these skulls came to exist gives me the shivers. How did they become so deformed?
Investigators first try to establish when this mysterious culture with elongated craniums existed.
Radiocarbon dating tells us these skeletons are between 5,000 and 12,000 years old.
Along with these skeletons, we found a wealth of material objects, grave goods, decorative pieces.
These few artifacts hint at this enigmatic culture being pioneers.
So these individuals in ancient Chinese society appear to be rather special. From what we can tell, they were hunter-gatherers, they had a decent diet, and they made unique, technically sophisticated pottery, all suggesting that they were an advanced culture.
But these Neolithic people left no clues why some of their heads became so bizarrely misshapen.
The length of these heads is clearly out of the ordinary, but one of the things that could explain this is a chronic bone condition, like osteoporosis or arthritis. But one that can actually cause reshaping of the skull is called Paget's disease.
But osteopathologists are not convinced, believing severe skull elongation is beyond Paget's capabilities.
Paget's disease usually causes a thickening and a widening of the bones rather than a lengthening. When we look at the CT scans, we can see that there is no bone disease. They're absolutely healthy bones. So there must be another explanation.
With bone disease eliminated, investigators question whether a cruel twist of genetics is to blame.
The funny thing about bones is we think of them as being static, and they're not. Bones are actually dynamic, much like any other organ of the body.
Babies' skulls are very different to adult skulls because the bones themselves are very flexible, and they're not all fused together. As babies age and start to become toddlers, the bones, they grow, they become slightly harder, and a lot of the cartilage in the skull also begins to ossify and harden.
If the sutures harden too early, before the skull's rapid growth phase, this can lead to elongation and misshaping of the skull.
This birth defect is known as craniosynostosis, and it afflicts about one in every 2,500 children born in the United States. Luckily for us, modern healthcare systems can quickly address this affliction.
But there's a potential flaw in this theory.
Without surgery, craniosynostosis results in shorter life expectancies.
Some of these people in Ho Tao Muga were around 40 when they died, which indicates quite a good long life.
Age profiling the skeletons actually reveals a wide range, from 3 years old right up to 40. Surviving to this relatively ripe old age rules out craniosynostosis as the cause of the misshapen skulls.
So on one hand, we know that these people did not suffer from a birth defect. On the other hand, we know that they did not suffer from a bone disease later in life. So what gives?
To find more clues why, scientists go digital, building a 3D model from one of the cone skulls' data. In the forensics lab, this allows archaeologist Karen Bellinger to explore the skull in a way never achieved before.
I'm looking at one of the cone skulls. This one is a female, 35 years of age. When compared to a regular human skull, you can really see how much more egg-shaped it is. The human skull is made of 8 cranial bones. The 3 largest are the frontal, parietal, and occipital. Looking at our cone skull, you can see clear areas that are flattened in the frontal, here, and occipital, here. This flattening is so extreme, it points to just one thing: intentional cranial modification. The dead giveaway is that the flattened bones are roughly parallel, suggesting that external pressure was applied, squashing the skull from top to bottom. What we're seeing here can only happen in the first few years of childhood, when the cranial bones are soft and malleable. This is a model of a child's skull. One of the most popular methods was to bind planks with a piece of cloth. This was continuously tightened like a crude vise, compressing the skull into this unnatural, elongated shape. Given one of these skulls dates back 12,000 years, it's among the oldest evidence we have for intentional cranial modification. That's amazing.
Forcibly reshaping human skulls has been recorded in a surprising array of ancient cultures.
The Mayans practiced it, the Incans practiced it, some South Pacific Island cultures practiced it. In Europe, the practice was most common where you had people that had migrated from Central Asia.
For some Native American tribes, like the Chinook, a purposefully flattened forehead was a sign of freedom.
But precious little was known about Neolithic cranial manipulation in China until this astonishing Ho Tao Muga discovery.
This could be ground zero for cranial manipulation across the region. It may have started here and then spread out over hundreds and thousands of years.
But we're still left with the question, why were these ancient Chinese people modifying their skulls? What was the goal here?
A clue lies in the artifacts accompanying the cone-skulled individuals.
The owners of these skulls were buried with lavish grave goods. And when we see, as archaeologists, lavish grave goods and cranial modification, this points to elite status. In this moment of the Neolithic world, class and status are becoming ever more important. Village leaders want to set themselves apart from the rest of the pack.
Not only could the Ho Tao Muga elite be the oldest cranial modifiers, they're also the longest, practicing this curious custom for a staggering 7,000 years, longer than any other culture.
I, for one, am happy this practice has not caught on in modern society. I kind of like my head the way it is right now.